like Seattle. It'll be a wet season. We won't have the winters anymore. Our climate are going to change. Exxon and these people are the ones with the money, the resources, and the ability to make the real shift. We can do what we can on our own. So what is the thing in your mind? You don't need to know. Just what it is in your mind. And this is your chance. You're kind of the person, the youth in our country, our generation, our job to address, step up to the plate, lay out the formula. Our generation made Facebook. We're the ones that can make changes. Old paradigm can't figure it out. That's why you're here. We're asking you. You're the youth. That's why he asked you. Sees you as the, you know, somebody with a conscious mind. So what is it that you really want to say? Don't even forget about these cameras. Forget about us. We're not here to judge what you have to say. We're not here to tell you what to say. This is your opportunity. We're trying to get the truth out of people. So whatever it is you want to say is the last thing.
There's only so much I can do. There's only so much the general populace can do. You hold the power. You have the money. You know how to propagate propaganda. If you take the money and the power that you have, and you truthfully tell the populace what's happening, and if you invest your money in things that can turn our economy and the ecology of the planet around, it's your obligation to do so. You have the money, you have the power, you've taken both, and now it's time to give back. Again, there's only so much I can do. There's only so much the layperson can do. It is up to you. You have the power. So do it.
If it was me and I was in my room, I would look at the head of Exxon and I would say, okay, how much money do you have in your bank account? You have $100 million, maybe you have $2 billion. What about the back coffers of cash that you guys believe you need for yourselves and your business executives? What if we were able to take the power back and enforce legislation that says, guess what, guys, all that money is no longer yours. That money is a global fund now to save our planet, because we have nothing left anymore. Because guess what? We've raped it. We lied to us. We could either mob up and create riots and take out your families, and we could say, fuck you, and put you to the stake like we did hundreds of years ago with our leaders. But we live in a civil society. So what is it that you can do to help that? You know?
Mm-hmm.
You know, what is it, like, I would say specifically, the money's gone, you take your money, but and when you start this one out, this one last one, you say, this is my address to the leaders of industry from Exxon Mobil on to the deforestation of our forest, down to Monsanto, and all you people who don't represent what we stand for on this planet. Something like that, you know, it's like, this is a message to you guys, not just say, I would say you.
What was the beginning of that?
This is kind of like a mess, you know, however you want to say it. This is a message to the leaders of global industries, examples like Exxon and Monsanto, the ones that aren't paying for our planet. Something along those lines. Doesn't have to be my exact words, however you want to say it. But this is your chance to, like, say something. Just refer to who you're speaking to in the beginning of it. What you might want to talk about Monsanto, it doesn't have to be Exxon. I'm just giving that idea. Take your time when you're ready. Actually, do me a favor. Close your eyes. Take a few deep breaths. Just breathe. Whenever you're ready, open them and go. say that, or whatever you like. It's not so specific. I'm just looking for something from you that's a little bit more direct, poignant, and like maybe angry, and like, you know, upset, and kind of emotional, and like, but you don't think of it as acting. Just,
right.
You know, I'm not trying to direct you. I'm just trying to get you to think about stuff. And, you know, I'm from Indiana. I know what, like, we live in a state that kind of cares about it, but doesn't.
Right.
And California definitely cares about it, but they don't. It's weird, you know, because people drive every day and pee and throw away, it's dirty, but they talk about it. And yeah, so, you whatever you want.
This is my message to the leaders of global industry, including Exxon, Monsanto, lobbyists, anyone who has put propaganda out there to obstruct the truth from the populace. You have raped and pillaged the natural planet. You've taken money not only from humanity, but from companies who could reverse the damage that you have knowingly promoted. It's time for you to give back. It's time for you to pull all of your propaganda and to start a conversation about what's actually happening and to start conversations about how we can fix it, about how you can fix it. You're the ones with the money. You're the ones with the influence. This is up to you. If you don't do it, no one else can.
Yeah. Is there anything else you want to say at 90 times? You're talking about anything. What's it like living in a city like Los Angeles from a place like Terre Haute and personalize your, like, you know, coming to a place that's overwhelming with millions of people who over-consume water? We're in a state that will no longer sustain itself due to water usage. And we also live in a world where our fresh water is melting and ice caps. Liquefying into the ocean. And that's not an issue. It's all the same. There's overfishing going on in Africa that's leading to overplankton buildups causing methane gas. Fukushima hasn't been cleaned up. Radiation is part of the problem that nobody's even speaking about. There was this past year, 100s of sea lions were showing up, baby sea lions showing up dead in the island and off the coast of California. Natural phenomenon occurring, massive fish kills. China, which we haven't even talked about, is the worst polluter in the world, and we all talk about it, but we don't enforce it. What does it take?
One of the things that was most shocking to me about coming to LA from Indiana was how shocked people were by my genuine responses to things. I like people. I like interacting with people. I like getting to know people. And I choose to believe the best in people. And I think that's a trait that is diminishing in the world, especially in big cities. Because in big cities, the conversations are happening about sustainability, about changing the ways that we live our lives on a day-to-day basis. But people don't know what to do about it. There are a lot of organizations that are working towards those goals, but there are so many barriers put up by the people in power, by the people that have the money, that it's making people jaded. I think if the people in power, the people with the money, the people with the influence, if they made an about face and stopped caring about personal gain and started caring about the health and well-being of the general population of the planet, everyone would be as genuine. It's not hard to let yourself respond naturally to something, but you put up all these barriers because there are all these barriers in your own life, all these barriers that you're trying to get past to make real changes in the world. And I don't know, I think economy reflects sociology. And if we're all in a place where bank accounts, we could actually change the economy, we could change the ecology, we could change how we are affecting the planet. I mean, maybe we could learn to live in harmony with it at some point in the future. But it's all up to the people who have the power, it's all up to the people who have the money, it's all up to the people who have thrown propaganda out there and tried to cover up what they're really doing.
Very nice. Feel like you covered everything you wanted to talk about?
I think so.
Thank you.
I hope you have some.
Have you met Matt?
Definitely.
We met briefly.
I know, I really.
I am Matt.
Hi.